The Netcode-Hub family, Frederick is here, and today we are diving into something super cool in .NET 9 that can be a game changer for our application development, which is Keyed Dependency Injection. Just imagine this, you are building an e-commerce platform, and yes, we all love those examples here at Netcode-Hub, isn't it? And that's right, so your app needs to calculate shipping costs, but here is the twist. You've got different shipping methods like standard shipping, express shipping, and maybe international shipping. All of these calculate cost differently. How would you design this in a clean, maintainable way without creating something like if-else statement? The answer is Keyed Dependency Injection. So you can define one interface, let's say an iShipping service, and then you have multiple implementation. But in the olden days, let me show you how we were doing it. And as a .NET 8, .NET 9, let's see how we can improve this. Less code and more efficient. I have a simple project here, which I've created, having an interface, one interface of an iShipping service, and then having multiple implementations for that. Let's check it out. In my project, I have the interface in here as iShipping service, which calculate the shipping cost based on the weight of the item. You want to calculate for the cost. Now the shipping service, you want to have multiple shipping services. We want to have the implementation of, so when we check our services, we have an express shipping, which faster, more expensive. So there is a calculation. You provide your weight, then I'm going to multiply it by this decimal value here. Okay. Now, when you check the international shipping, you can see I'm doing the same thing. And now, this international actually is higher rate for international. So, this is the type of amount that I'm just multiplying. Now, check it out. This is from the standard. So, you can see that each of the service that we have here has its own calculation. I mean, the amount, the rate. Now, in this case, we are having only one shipping service. How would you do it? In the olden days, that is what we used to do. So we need to go in and register all these services. So we first do singleton for all these services, so we instances can be created once at runtime when the app starts, which will be attached to any service that make call to that. Aside from that, we can add a singleton pass in our func, and in here we need to provide a key. And at this key, we are making a switch. So here, instead of using this if else, we can just use this to switch. We're providing, if it is standard, we want to get the standard shipping service. If it is express, we want to do that, attached to this interface, which has been provided. If it is international, well, do the same. And in case it is not any here, then you know what to do. We have a default value. After registering this, adding this service, you need to use this func in the controller so you can choose the service that you want based on the endpoint that you have created. So here in a controller, you can see we are injecting our func of string with the interface, and we create an instance of it. And in here, we need to pass in a key that's an express, standard, and international. So this key must be the same as what we used to over here in the program.cs. So it's advisable, if you want to use this, you can create a static class, a constant for this key, so that you can handle them without having any typo in it. That was the olden day. Okay, so this is what we need to do. Now you can see from the controller, we are getting a express shipping service attached to our interface, and then we can get access to that. So you see the same amount, but we're going to have different values. So international gives you this international, standard for standard, and express for express. Let's run it and see how it works and how we're using it in the olden day. All right, so that is ready. Now let's check the controller, which is, I think, shipping. So you want to locate shipping, express shipping, standard, and now shipping international with the same predefined values here. Let's go and check this out. So from the service running, you want to check for shipping. Then another shipping, we want to look up for express. Now, since we have the amount defined already, So we are having 135.9. The same thing applies to if we use for standard, we have the same amount, but check the price, 67. And also let's go for the international and check it out, 226. So you see that the same amount, but when you use different service, it gives you different values. And that tells you that we're able to bound our service to our interface. Great. But the process here is quite cumbersome, too long to do this. Is there any simple way to use it? Yes. In .NET 8.9, we can use key dependency injection. Key dependency injection, that is where we specify our keys. So instead of using this key over here, the keys that we have specified in the service here, standard, express, international, we can decide to specify the keys straight away. So let's do that. Let's comment this because this is no more needed. Then I'm going to copy this key, and with this interface that I'm going to provide it here, go straight at the interface. After adding this interface, grab the key here and I'll pass the key down here. You can also create the same thing, the same key in a constant and pass it on, okay? So that you don't duplicate the keys. So you can pass on the key over here. But instead of using add singleton, no, we need to do add keyed singleton. Are you getting the catch? Great. So we're going to do the same. All right, so now that we are done with this, what's the next thing that we got to do? Let's go to the controller and let's start using this. So we should not forget these keys, right? So in here, we go to our controller. And now with all this, we don't need to use this anymore. That's what we need to do. So I'm going to make a copy of this. And let me just comment this here so we can paste this as a new version. Okay. And here we need to use key dependency injection here in our controller. So within this, I'll give space. So this is all you need from keyed service. This is an attribute. Now this attribute, you need to specify the name. So let's say you want to get an express. And now the key here should match exactly what you specify in the program.cs. That is why it is advisable to have it in a constant or in a separate class so you can go in and use it there and here. But here you need to specify the key. And let's make the same thing. Now we have standard. Then we have international. After you're done with this, have your interface. So our service that we created was shipping service, right? So there's going to be express shipping. Then we're going to have same thing, but with this standard. Finally, we're going to have our international. Good. So once you have our interface, what is the next step? We go in and use this interface. So from the express, we come to the express. We can now get rid of this line. Then we can say express.calculate shipping cost. We go to the standard. We do same, get rid of this line. Replace it. And lastly, for the international, get rid of this. Replace it. So that is what we need to do. Register from the settings here, that's the program.cs, give it a special key, use the key to retrieve it over here, and I'll use it. Quite simple, right? Now let's run it and see whether we're going to achieve same. So let's go in and check for our shipping service, and then we have our express. Now because we have the same amount, let's go in for our standard, the same thing. Now let's go in for international. We got the same thing. And that is it, folks. So key dependency injection is such a simple yet powerful way to keep your code clean and scalable, right? So no more messy with if else change. Just clean design and easy maintainability. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more awesome.net content. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.